with the flip is up to nation.
First of all, my voice is extremely hoarse in this video. I lost my voice completely at the show, and I was getting it back. I was sipping on tea, you know. So that's why I'm kind of talking a little quieter, just letting you know.
As you can see, I just got back from the Fine Line album release show. Christelle somehow got a ticket. I think her phone is magical. She got in line like 5 minutes after I did, and she somehow just soared through the queue. I don't know how. So she was able to get 2 tickets for us, which was amazing. So I just wanted to take this time and talk about my experience. I also reacted to the Fine Line album, the whole thing. Christelle had her friend Carly visit us, and she also got a ticket to the release show somehow. Somehow she was able to soar through the queue too, I don't know. But she was here staying with us for the show, and she reacted to it with us. Since I have 2 other people with me, we wanted to make this a very authentic experience. Carly isn't a YouTuber, she doesn't really make videos, and I didn't want her to feel weird about being on camera, this being like an official YouTube video where we're reacting to the album. My friends are made as a YouTuber, you know what I'm saying? So I just kind of set up the camera in the corner. They knew that I was recording, but I told them, I was like, you guys, just pretend like the camera's not here. Let's have this be an authentic experience just for us. And by the time we actually started listening, it was 1 a.m. and I have neighbors, and we were trying to be respectful also, so we weren't gonna scream and shit. But I still wanted to film a reaction video first listen. But first, let's go talk to Future Sarah, because she got this video sponsored. Thank God. Here you go, sweetie. And let's see what she has to say. Take it away, girl. I just wanted to give a huge shout out to SeatGeek for sponsoring today's video. If you don't already know, SeatGeek is an awesome app that helps you buy tickets to live events in the easiest way possible. They have tickets to everything, basketball games, live concerts, festivals, you name it. The best part is if you use my code Sarah, you can get $20 off your first purchase. Go ahead and click the link in my description, download the app, and don't forget to use my code Sarah so you get $20 off. Okay, past Sarah, back to you, girly. Thank you so much, Future Sarah, for that. Let's start off the video by showing the reaction to the Fine Line album. If you don't want to watch us reacting, click to this number because the second part of the video is us going to the show. So yeah, it kind of just jumps right in. Here's that.
Of this album, and we have so much to go.
Okay.
Me as I'm saying belly, the worst word ever. I hate that word.
I was wondering why they included that.
Belly of all things.
Hey y'all, that shit fucked me up.
This song too just like fucks me up.
Oh my god!
That's the only thing I ever do.
Oh my god!
Never come back down.
I do love this song so much.
Me too.
I never get sick of it. Wait, this is kind of beautiful. Guitar on the wedding.
Don't you call him baby. still talk to them.
Oh.
Does he take my jingles to call?
Imagine,
dude,
like,
I
how
stalked
great
her Instagram and she seems great.
She does seem
she,
great.
Like, imagine how great you. It literally feels like I like invaded his privacy.
Yeah.
Like
it
read
feels
his
like I read his diary.
At one
too
point
much.
In there, I was like, oh my god, like
should
he,
we be knowing this?
He really
he loved her.
Up.
Dude, okay, have you seen that one commercial with Rob Pattinson and that girl making out in the
yes.
elevator? It's her.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Imagine
Camille.
Kissing
That's
fucking
Camille.
Edward Cullen and Harry Styles.
And there's no one to blame but the drink and my wandering hands.
Huh?
Forget what happened. What if I'm someone I don't want around? I'm falling again. I'm falling.
This album is so fucking naked.
Wait. What?
I literally feel like
I'm reading
his diary.
His diary.
It's like drinking in his wandering hands.
Yeah,
oh my god,
like,
that would break my heart.
But it's like,
in the
yeah.
interview with Zane Lowe, he was like, I was noticing this pattern that
yeah.
I was going down. Like, I don't want to be
amazing.
That.
Amazing.
It's so good.
This song is so hard.
Sailing away.
that was a masterpiece.
Describe that experience. It was just so wholesome. It was a magical time, and I'm never gonna forget that moment.
So the next footage you're about to see is me on my way to pick up Caitlin at the airport. I was an hour late picking her up because of traffic, and I felt really bad about it, but hey, I still picked her up. It's all good.
All right, y'all, so today's the day. Today is the day. Oh my God. It is Harry Day. I'm so excited. I just listened to the whole album again on my way to the airport. I'm picking up Caitlin. I'm just so happy that she's here to witness the magic with all of our friends. She flew in from Boston, actually New York. She went to New York to get her hair done. So I'm wearing a red outfit. I'll show you guys later. I have these red glittery pants and they're phenomenal. I'm gonna wear a black shirt with that. But I was at the nail salon yesterday, right? And all of my friends are doing like the blue pink nails because, you know, fine line, blue pink. So they all have blue pink nails and I was gonna do that too. Chill. I was at the nail salon yesterday and I picked out a blue and a pink shade. And as I'm sitting down and she's like buffing up my nails and shit, I was like, oh wait, that would look like garbage with my outfit. I for some reason forgot that I was wearing an all red and black outfit for Cherry. I felt so bad. I kept asking the lady at the front to like keep changing the colors. I decided to go with these red nails and they're glittery. Maybe we can. Oh, and I got a spray tan too. Looks kind of orange though. The lady at the tanning place was like, do you want to look like you just spent a week at Palm Springs, or do you want to look like you just got back from Hawaii? I'm like, huh? What's the difference? So I said Hawaii. So I just got back from Hawaii, y'all. I look kind of orange, but it's fine. You live and you learn. Okay, she said she's at 3 something. I have my Polaroid out. I want to take a picture of her. I'm like a mom picking up their kid from school. Hey, sweetie, smile. On their first day. I fucking hate LAX. Oh, wait, this is Delta. This is Delta. Woo! I should probably move all my shit. Yeah! Woo woo! Oh my God! Oh my God!
Hey, bitch!
Oh, here we are!
So we both
them spray tans?
Yes, dude. I'm so orange.
I literally need to exfoliate all the spray tan that is stuck to all my dry skin and acne so bad.
Same.
Oh my god, I'm in your car and it's tonight.
It's tonight.
Well, it's today right now, but like tonight is the night.
How do you feel about the album?
Oh, I wish I started listening to it when it was leaked low-key. I'm not ready and I don't know any of the words.
Me either. But it's so good.
Should we print out lyrics?
We just have a read-along at the show.
We're handing out like flyers. Like, yes. Here are the lyrics. It's like a stapled booklet. Yeah. We charge like 50 cents for each one. We make a shit ton of money. Yes.
So after that, we went home. We took a shower, right? The show started at 7. So in our minds, Harry was going to be on stage right at 7 opening up with Golden, aka my favorite song, aka I can't miss it. So we were gonna leave at 4:30. Once we get there, we would sit in my car in the parking lot and we would start to pregame. Our friend Sydney was gonna meet us after the show and she was gonna drive my car back to our house. Sydney doesn't drink, so she was down to drive the car back. We weren't gonna drive drunk, okay? You know me, I'm not that type of bitch. I would never do that. I would never put myself in danger like that. We're all getting ready, right? Planning on leaving at 4:30. Well, there's 5 girls getting ready for a Harry show. We didn't leave at 4:30.
We left at 5:30.
The worst time to drive in LA. So we leave the house at 5:30.
When I say Harry, you say Styles. Harry!
Styles!
Harry!
Styles!
Yes! Let's go!
I don't wanna make you feel bad, but I've been trying hard not to talk to you.
One driving and it says that we're gonna get there at 6:30. So we're like, okay, we got like 30 minutes to pregame, it'll be chill.
But
the destination time kept going higher and higher and higher to the point where it said 6:40 was gonna be our destination time. All the girlies in the car are getting anxious at this point. We don't even know if there's gonna be enough room to park since we're so late. We can't miss Golden. We finally get to the venue at 6:50.
How are we feeling?
I'm nervous.
Like Leia said, it feels like we're about to go on our first day.
Yeah. Okay, it's green. It's fun. It's fun. Let's go. What does that sign say? No more general parking. VIP. Okay, VIP. Wait, VIP list?
Yeah.
But I'm not on a list. If it's $100, I don't care.
Okay, we're fine. We're fine. We're
just bribed.
Like where? If it's not. Where are we gonna go?
Literally ditch the car.
I mean,
my car.
No, I was kidding.
Should we just park at that gas station or some shit?
Bro, your car will get towed.
I don't even care. I'll pick it up at the tow.
No, it's like $700.
Oh, we can ask her.
Sorry. Bribe her. We'll give you $500.
No, can we pay for VIP here?
They're not taking any. You can't pay. You have to be on the list already.
Okay, go.
Even
go,
for like $500.
We will all put in $100.
Wait, is that event parking right there? Oh, it literally says event parking.
Okay, he's not going on at 7.
No, yeah. No, he's not. Oh, look at this.
Beautiful.
Probably so expensive, but I don't
give a shit.
Hi.
Yes.
Thanks, Lord.
Oh, God.
Whoa. Oh, God. Hello.
How much is it?
It's $30.
Oh, no, not.
Hurry. Okay.
Sorry.
Did
you take a card? Get my card.
Yes.
You guys late?
Yeah.
Should have camped it out like everybody else.
Oh, no way.
No, I have a job.
Stupid.
Fucking
no. Thanks. I have a job.
I'm literally taking these off.
Your shoes?
Love that for you.
To run? No, yeah. I can run in these.
Yeah. Oh my god, yes.
We made it.
Okay.
That's cheaper than parking too.
So at this point, we're like, dope. Okay, great. But we only have like 5 minutes to pregame.
Not even 5, like 1.5. Maybe 2.
We were stressed, we were anxious, feeling all the emotions because we're like, we can't miss Golden.
Okay. Y'all, bottles up. Put your hands up. Bottles on, a couple bottles, but a couple ain't enough.
Go, you know, Christelle.
Everyone is doing amazing.
Yeah.
Let's go. Can someone open this? I have found two of it. We are on the road to success. You're doing it. Come on, Leia. You got this. One more time. Pretend we're listening to Daft Punk. One more time, baby.
One more time. We're gonna celebrate. Oh, yeah. All right. Don't stop the dancing.
I was just yacked.
Okay,
real quick. Sorry.
Don't
okay.
I won't be a bear.
I'm not a bear.
Oh, I thought you were like,
not a
ew.
No.
Okay, ladies.
Wait, okay, I'm ready.
Let's go, John.
Grab your phone. Let's go.
Three, okay. Two, okay. Wait.
Walking up to the venue, and everybody is just outside playing hacky sack, playing ring toss, playing all these little games outside, sitting on the ground like on their phones, looking bored. And we're all just like, hello, what are y'all doing? And this one girl comes up to us and she's like, oh, he's not gonna come on until 7:30. And we're all like, right. Why? And she was like, I don't know, there's been some issues like in the forum. And we're like, okay, we can finally relax. We all go up to the general admission line to show them the tickets, and they're like, oh,
y'all need a wristband.
And we're like, huh? Where the fuck do we find that? And they're like, oh, do you see that really long line that like wraps around the forum? You have to stand in that. So we're like, okay, awesome. So we stand in this really long line. It was cool because like I met a lot of you guys. A lot of you guys are so sweet. We took some pictures. It was cute. But we were all really anxious because we're like, oh my God, he's gonna come on in 30 minutes. And this is like a 45 minute line. This is stressful. We get our wristbands right at 7:30. Our little booties run to the general admission. We walk in. We were all just chilling in the back, you know, drinking some brewskis. There was a bar right next to the general admission, like right next to us. So we were getting faded. We weren't trying to get drunk because I wanted to remember it. You know what I'm saying? We're talking to fans. We're dancing around. And at this point, I'm like, wait, I feel like we've been dancing around for a really long time. What time is it? I check my phone. It's 8:00. He's definitely coming on right now. So we were all just waiting, nothing. We're like, okay, we'll dance it out. Where the fuck is Harry? And then this girl comes up to us and she's like, oh my God, there's been so much drama. And I guess this creepy man bought a general admission ticket and was like in the middle of the pit going around groping girls. So creepy. And if you were one of those girls that had to deal with that, I'm so sorry that happened to you. That's disgusting. But apparently it took an hour for the security to get him out of the venue, which is baloney. I can't believe it took that long. Then I guess there were some issues with the tickets not being scanned. I don't know why the forum is so unorganized when it comes to these certain things. You would think that they would have it down by now. You're the forum. Come on, y'all. So I guess that's why it was taking so long.
What?
There was something peculiar that happened. Everyone was screaming that Niall was there. We're all frantic. My little One Direction heart was gonna burst that Niall was there. In the VIP section, we see just blonde hair, and we're all like,
Niall!
What?
Then the lights just turn off. And I had a full beer and I was talking to a fan, and I feel so bad for this fan, but I was so manic once the lights turned off and it was pitch black and everyone was screaming. But I needed to finish this beer so I could dance, right? And I was talking to this fan and I was like, count me down from 10. And she was just like, what? And I was like, just do it. And she was like, okay, 10, 9. And I was like,
Get your dirty minds out of the gutter. That was a chugging motion. Perverts.
We have one job tonight, and that's to entertain you. Give you my word, we'll do our absolute best, but you also have one job. That's to have as much fun as you possibly can.
So stoked for the guitar solo, but I didn't know I was gonna be that stoked. And I got on the ground, and y'all, I wasn't doing this for attention. I was just literally imagining myself as Mitch. We somehow formed a circle around me and Caitlin, and it was a lot of like you guys. And I kind of do wish that I looked up at some point during that guitar solo so I could see what Harry was doing on stage, or like even just seeing Mitch do it. But I was just so like grounded in that moment. That was the only way I could escape that energy.
She sleeps in bed. She's a person that I see, and I don't know what I don't know who she is.
Yeah, it was dope. He got to Fine Line, the last song on the album. I also thought that that was the last song that he was gonna perform, then he was gonna go off stage and the concert was over. And I got so emotional, you guys. Bitch, and I didn't think I was gonna cry. It takes a lot for me to cry in front of people, and the fact that I just broke during Fine Line, it says a lot. And that song live was just way different experience than hearing it, you know, on my mega boo. And after that song was over, this motherfucker comes out and starts singing Sign of the Times. I was sobbing during Sign of the Times too, like I couldn't stop crying. It was kind of embarrassing. The fact that this bitch, one of the lyrics is, stop your crying, baby, it'll be all right. Like he knew we were all crying. And once he said, stop your crying, I was like, okay, I'm sorry, I'm trying. Like, I'm trying to stop. And I didn't want to cry. I had really bomb makeup. Was too much, him directly telling us to stop crying right after Fine Line, like what? After Sign of the Times, this bitch performs What Makes You Beautiful, and that was like a full circle for me, because then that plugged me back into the emotions of like, oh my god, this man is literally the reason why I have these friends that are here with me, these fans that are dancing with me. It was too much. So I was crying even harder during What Makes You Beautiful, which is like the most like, baby, you light up. Like I should have been like twerking my ass off, but I'm literally holding my chest like, like scream crying. A fan literally saw me and just gave me the biggest bear hug, and I was crying in this fan's arms like, I love you, man. Like, he's the reason why that we're even like, and she was like, I know. So I appreciate you, girl, for being there for me during that. Then he played Kiwi, which like brought me out of that emotional state. I'm like, I'm having your baby. The tears were drying during that song, and I was like, it's none of your business. It took me back to like, oh, I'm gonna twerk my ass off. This is fun. Okay.
Please welcome to the stage, Miss Stevie Rich.
Time makes older, children get older, I'm getting older too.
It's almost Christmas time. Yeah! No, I need the words to this song.
Bitch, stop!
What is he doing?
Also, such a beautiful moment that Christelle had with Harry's mom, Anne. She was standing right next to us in the back of general admission. She was standing with the sound tech people, and it was barricaded off, so she was like safe in a barricade. And we talked about this for Caitlin's video. I'm gonna insert the part where Christelle's talking about it because I want her to tell the story.
My drunk ass sees your drunk ass.
Oh, thumbs up to my drunk ass.
I see your drunk ass walking over to Anne, and I just think that you're gonna like scream at her to say some shit. So I was like, Christelle, no, no, don't.
She literally comes up to me and is like, get Christelle. And I was like, where is she?
And then we look over and you're like on your way to
we're like,
Anne.
No.
We're like, Christelle.
I go up to her and I'm like, Anne. And I'm not even yelling. I'm literally just like, Anne. Like, that was my volume. And she looks over at me and I was like, I just want to say thank you.
Start reading the Declaration of Independence.
Yeah, I'm like,
pulls out a scroll.
Yeah, hear ye, hear ye.
But I go up to her and I was like, thank you so much. And I like point at the stage and she starts
as if you have to clarify.
Are you saying this?
Yeah.
And I was like, are you saying this?
But then she like giggled. She was like, haha, funny. You're like thanking me for birthing my son. And I was like, but then, and she was giggling, but I was like, no, but seriously though.
No.
I don't listen to me.
Oh my God. This was like so crazy because seeing her face change from like, ha 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 to like, was so, it made me cry. Like, I couldn't finish talking to her because I was like, I was like, thank you so much. Like, he is the reason all of my friends know each other. Mm-hmm. He is the reason I am here. He changed our lives. Thank you. Mm-hmm. And I start crying because her face is just like, and then mm-hmm. I was like, thank you so much. I'm sorry. And I like turned around and
then just and lost
then
it.
And you're like, and then everyone just starts hugging me, and she's just watching everyone hugging me.
We do the cutest group hug ever.
Half of the people didn't even know what just happened. No. Like, they just saw that I was crying and started hugging
me. Yeah.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, he is the reason I have these friends that give a fuck enough to give me a group hug just because I'm crying.
Yeah.
Like, that's what I'm fucking talking about. And she saw that firsthand, and she was just like,
she was smiling at us. Yeah. She was like, oh.
And then right after that, me and Sarah kind of walked off to the side, and Sarah was like, don't turn around, don't look, but Anne is looking at us right now.
Yeah.
And I was like, shut up. And so I didn't look at her for the rest of the night. And then apparently,
so I didn't want to like look over at her, so I didn't want to make her feel weird. I was just looking from the corner of my eye, and her head was just always in our direction.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I could like kind of see her being like,
yeah, she was doing
especially
a smirk.
Especially with like all of us wearing all this glitter.
Yeah.
And then Leia with her light up jacket and all of us with her arms up, like doing high kicks,
arms
getting
up,
on the
floor.
I mean,
on the
legs in the air.
Legs.
Yeah. Legs up.
And then after that, we met up with my friend Sydney and she drove us home. She was so hurt. We got back home and we just talked about the experience.
Right after
are
fall.
You okay?
All
like,
Harry
bro,
hears.
Bro, and then it's like,
What
is going on? Nothing you guys are saying is making any sense.
When Harry finishes his song,
if everyone said bruh,
I got a song falling. Everyone in the pit. From every direction.
But like it's like
bruh.
They keep hitting each other.
Anna is right next to me.
Bruh.
She does
it too. She
goes bruh. Bra.
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 No.
Bra.
All the Americans.
Bruh. Bruh.
She does it in deep voice.
Bruh.
Bruh.
That was one of the best nights of my life, and I'm never gonna forget it. I'm just so thankful for Harry. Thank you for everything you've done for me. Like, he's watching this. My camera died right as I was closing the video out, so I'm just glad that I got to take you guys along on this journey. If you have an opportunity to go see Harry, please do it. It's such a good show. Leave a comment. Tell me your favorite songs on Fine Line. Thanks for watching.
That you're scared because I'm so open.